Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. Thank you for joining me here on Music with Todd Ledbetter. We are going to check out some cheap trick. Now, this is the first time I think we're going to do cheap trick on the channel. I recently got kind of interested in cheap trick for the channel. And I, you know, have heard some of the hits over, you know, growing up back in the day. And one thing I have not heard is their very first album. Basically, I haven't heard a lot from them, but their very first album, just called Cheap Trick, was released in 1977. It's 10 minutes and it's 40, 10 songs, excuse me, not 10 minutes, 10 songs and it's 40 minutes. And we're going to play a song, let's see, you know, not a lot of listens on this album. And this song's called Taxman, Mr. Thief. Kind of reminds me of a Beatles song, so I'm kind of curious about it. So that's where I know it's not going to be a Beatles song, but maybe kind of like the same sort of kind of theme. You know what I'm saying? So let's check that out. We're going to check out 1977 Cheap Trick, Taxman, Mr. Thief from their debut album. We'll be right back. Cool. Wow, I don't think I expected that from their first album. That was kind of rocking. It was definitely rocking. I like that. I thought that was good. It kind of did sound like when they said "Tax Man, Mr. Thief," it kind of did sort of sound a little bit, Beatles-ish in a way. Let's see. So that's their first album. Now, totally unaware. I don't know this album at all. I don't know if I've heard any of these songs or not. But there was a point, like in high school, when I was, playing bass and lead singing in a band. We did. I think the live at Budokan was, in 78. So there you are. 78 is the year I came out of eighth grade and went into ninth grade. And so we played, we played like Surrender, Clock Strikes 10, those kind of things back in those days. So that was just the next year after, so that was 78. So we just listened to a song from 77. So I never went back and listened to that album for whatever reason. And then I've heard like, so they had two albums in 77 and then three albums In Color. Wow. Well, this has songs that was on the Budokan album too, like Hello There, Big Eyes, I Want You to Want Me, Clock Strikes 10. A lot of those songs came off of this album, actually, the In Color album. Okay, I'm just looking at Spotify and checking all this out. It's kind of going through it. And then Dream Police, of course, I heard, Dream Police and Voices. I remember that song. I like that song too. So I think what I'm trying to say is that I've always liked Cheap Trick because it was kind of an interesting dichotomy of, they always showed like Robin Zander and I forget the bass player's name, like the two of them a lot of times. And then they would show Rick Nielsen and Bunny Carlos together and kind of like the good looking rockers with the kind of funky looking guys, but they always really seemed to rock, And back then that's the kind of music I liked. And, but I just never really dove into their catalog and their songs really, really much. So it's kind of interesting to hear something early. I was actually a little bit surprised by how much I liked that song, for just a song that I just decided to play and nobody requested it or recommended it. But good stuff. I liked it. All right. Let me know what you think. Are you a Cheap Trick fan? Have you seen these guys live? Because I know they've been playing around live for a long time. Who did they play with? Did they open up for anybody? Who opened up for them once they got bigger? Give me a little history of your relationship with Cheap Trick, if you would, down in the comments. So thank you guys. Make sure you subscribe to the channel and like it and all that kind of stuff, whatever platform you're on. And make sure that you go to my Ko-Fi to recommend songs. That really helps out the channel. And also Patreon is a good place for that as well. So we'll see you in the next video. And you guys have a great day, whatever's left of it for you. And we'll talk to you later. Thank you for being here. I appreciate you all. Bye.